Thank you. Mheshimiwa Bosire and your family. The Right Honorable Prime Minister, Governor Nyaribo, Governor Ongwae, Governor Nyanyong, all the senators, members of parliament, and all the MCAs, na wananchi wa Nyamira. Yangu, kwa kawaida, ni machache. Lakini ukichokosa mzee kidogo kutoka mahali ya maketi, ataongeza mawili matatu juu yake. Kwa leo, nimekuja kusema pole sana. I've had an occasion to discuss with you as a family, and I listened very carefully when you were giving your eulogy here and your children. I could perceive and see the pain you are going through, and you are almost telling us that there is a gap that has been created in your life. You even went to an extent of telling us that you are acting, you are in a very strange situation. What I picked from that message, our first duty and responsibility is to try and bring you up from a strange situation to a normal situation. That's why when Mama Jane slept, she was a very staunch Christian. And you remember, I did mention, and thank you, Pastor, for that opportunity you gave us. I did mention that she did her part as a Christian. She has now gone to sleep. And I told you, Psalms 116, verse 15, says, precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful servants. She's been a faithful servant to the Lord. She's gone to sleep. I think precious in English terminology, and you're very good in English, is when something that has no value. You cannot assign a value to it. That's what your wife was. And you've stood here as a testament to the public that you need that comfort. You said you don't know from where. But I also know, because we must come and encourage you. I also know that in this troubled situation you are in, and again I said, in Isaiah 26, verse 3, it clearly tells us, when you are in this kind of a strange situation, the Lord says he will keep you in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts you. And I think that's what I want to leave that message to you now. Mwenyezi akubeke in his perfect situation. And I would have gone further, like Paul himself, at that strange moment, when he was sick and he was feeling the kind of pain you are feeling today, he quoted in 2 Corinthians 12 verse 9, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in your weakness. This is the weakest moment you are in, brother, and we want to wish you well. And I want to wish you well that God's grace, God's power will be with you. And the verse continues saying, I shall delight, or I shall rejoice in my weakness, because I know when I'm weak, then I'm strong. Be strong in the Lord, and this is what we came to give you as a testimony to everybody here, that while we're still alive, we should keep very strong. Bas, hayo ni ya Mungu, iko ya Kaisari. Montegarre Morasana. Monte Guerrero Rosana. Haraka raka, haina baraka. Nimesikia maneno imepita chuu tu, imetambaa kila mahali. Nakumbuka uwezi kuharibu mahali unatoka. Lazima ukijonga boma yako usiharibu boma yako mahali unatoka. Osire, you have been a faithful member of ODM party. You have been a very strong pillar. And the Right Honorable Prime Minister, I want to thank you for standing with Bosire. Hii kitu nimesikia eke Bosire ngekuwa nanga bottom up tima yitingida kwane eke aronda era abili eke ntukio bosoku. This thing they call bottom up is very basic. We're talking about empowering people at the grassroots to come up. And if you know, just in case you have forgotten, the first minister for Jua Kali, technical training and applied technology, yours truly, Professor Sam Ongeri, 1988. So there's nothing new you are telling us today here. There's nothing new about this bottom-up approach. What you should be telling us, 2007, when there was a coalition government, this was strengthened by vocational and technical training and applied technology. We increased the skills of people. We should therefore be now empowering them to grow further and further and create micro enterprises and small enterprises. So don't come here and try and tell us that, oh, we have a new economic policy, which was started in 1988. We have been refining it. We have brought it up the level where it is. And the BBI was trying to even refine it further by increasing the resources to 35% of the county. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Baba. Your handshake, these people were shaken to the core. They didn't know what to do. The handshake brought unparalleled peace to this nation. You cannot bargain against peace. There's no way you can bargain against peace. Peace is the hallmark of everything. Instead of saying thank you to these two great leaders, you are busy trying to speak some other languages hapo nje ambayo hata ieti haingii. My advice, sincere advice, there is unity in diversity. Let's collect ourselves together. Let's move together with one purpose, one intention. We have been given the leadership. We should follow. All other things are peripheral. They don't add up. Let's follow the path which has been charted out by our top two leaders, and I'm sure we shall be able to achieve the lasting peace. Finally, the Bible says in 1 Peter 3, if you read from verse 8 up to 11, 8, 9, 10 talks about how we should live together in harmony, in peace, having blessings for one another. But finally says, seek peace and pursue it. And I thank Baba, you are seeking peace and you are pursuing it, and we shall be behind you to seek that peace and pursue it. God bless you. Hello.